what led me to making Dancing Auschwitz. And Dancing Auschwitz, by the way, is it used to be a four-part installation, 1, 2, 3, 4, but now it's a multi-part installation, 1, 2, 3, 4, and my dad. As living art, so dad's living art, 91-year-old living art man, and also what's new in this Dancing Auschwitz revisited is the email response from around the world, some email response, and I booked it to love, hate and healing. Anyway, so what was going on in my mind before I did this work? And I just say I've been an artist all my life, and about 6 years ago I decided to see what I didn't know. So I went back to university to study fine art. And after a few years I was doing honours, and I got stuck. And I didn't know what to do, because all I could think about doing was work on the Jew. And I was like, I can't do work on the Jew. And it's too difficult, too uncomfortable, too uneasy. But I couldn't think of anything else, because that's what just kept coming up. And so I made a t-shirt, tattoo on it, and I just wanted to understand why this word was so heavy and so scary. Could I really go out, with this on my t-shirt, and what did that mean? And what were the associations of being a Jew? Did it mean I was a scapegoat, so I made some goat horns, and I walked down the street in Ashburton, and then I made some accessories for my face, and I made a big nose, and I thought, does that mean I'm a Jew? What does it mean to be a Jew? I know the propaganda, I know the stereotypes, I know what, some people have called Jews, but I didn't know myself what a Jew was. So anyway, I went back, it brought me back, thinking about the Jew, to when I was a little girl. And when I was a little girl, I was coming home from school one day, and I was I was told that I killed Jesus. And there's my next teacher. And I didn't know who Jesus was when I was 6. And I was very upset that I was told that I killed Jesus. And so I made a t-shirt saying, I didn't kill Jesus. I'm sorry, but I didn't kill him. I know who Jesus is now, but that was quite heavy on that stuck in my mind as a 6-year-old. And anyway, so all these are thoughts that are going in my head over the years, maybe through my whole life, maybe the last few years. And that led me to thinking about this, and this sign, this Star of David, the Shield of David. It was meant to be like quite a positive sign, a symbol. But then it became twisted, and it became a sign of humiliation, and a sign that, only selected people have to wear, and they're separate from other people, and they're persecuted. So that made me also think about what it meant to be a Jew. And so then I'm thinking more and more, and then I'm thinking, hold on, this exhibition's about, the collective Australian consciousness. What does that mean? And I knew that, I was made in Australia. So I was maybe saying, what does that mean now? Jews, David, Jesus, in Australia. What sort of artwork can I make? And then that led me to thinking about, I went to Israel, and I lived 18 years in Israel because I married someone who wanted to live in Israel, and I went to live in Israel. And it was a very interesting experience. Fantastic, I had some kids who were made in Israel. So, what did that mean? There was this straddling two worlds in a way. And then I started to think more that I'd been reading the news, and I'd been reading things like I have a victim mentality. The Jews have a victim mentality. The Jews have been persecuted for years and years and years and generations and centuries. Oh, so I must have a victim mentality. Then I was told that maybe I'm a person, so the perpetrator. So I didn't know, am I a victim, am I the perpetrator? I was very confused. So I kept reading the papers and trying to find an answer, just made me more confused. And then, then back at uni, one of my teachers sees that I'm quite obsessed. As artists become, they become obsessed. And his teacher said, listen Jay, I think you should listen to some advice. I think you should go back to Poland. I think you should go back to Europe, back to where your parents were born, back to where they grew up, back to where they spent their years in the war. Just go back. And go back because your parents are alive. Your parents are alive, you're very lucky. Go back with your parents and go back with your children. It's a very unique opportunity. And I was never interested in going back. What did Poland mean to me? I didn't really want to go. But I went home and I spoke to my kids and I said, hey, this crazy teacher's got an idea. We should go back. And my kids said to me, after some thought, you know what, Mum? It's a very special, important thing to do. And so we gathered the kids who were in different countries of the world, and my niece, and we met together in Poland. And as this project came about, as this plan of all the family being together, I thought, well, I'm an artist. I might as well do something with this opportunity. I might as well make some art. What would I make? And then I thought, what is important for me? And what's important for me is my parents' attitude to life. My parents have always celebrated life. They've always danced, they've always had compulsory dress-up parties. They've always invited all their friends, who are mostly survivors, to come and dance. And the people couldn't come to, their friends couldn't come to their house unless they were dressed up and unless they danced. And this happened through the 60s and the 70s and the 80s and the 90s. And Dad used to video them, the parties, and compile them. And so there's all these videos. So anyway, so I thought about dancing. We could dance at Auschwitz and Terenstadt and Dachau as a family, because that sort of speaks about my growing up kids and my family and how I was raised and how I was influenced. Then I thought, what can we dance to? How can we dance? And the only thing I knew was a dance that I learned at a counterpoint church. It was called Better Dance, it went like that. And that's the only dance I knew. So that's what I taught my family, to dance. And then I thought, what sort of song could we use? And I Googled survival. Survivor. And I came across a few, but in the end I chose Gloria Gaynor. Because Gloria Gaynor's song was special because it had the beat. But besides that, it was about minorities. Like Gloria Gaynor was a black woman and she sang about, you know. And she also sang about, you know, doesn't even anymore. Get out the door and I don't want her anymore. And but it was also used by sort of Queen of the Desert by the transvestites. And they also sang in the desert. So I thought, okay, now it's due to make a single. And so I chose the song, I had the dance, I had the idea, I made some t-shirts, I made Survivor for Dad, because he was a survivor of, you know, the camps and the camps. I made Second Gen, because apparently children of survivors are known as second generation. And I made Third Generation, because apparently the children of survivors are known as Third Generation. We all had our t-shirts. And so that's the background to this work. Now about the work.